Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will show you how to make this fake volumetric smoke. If you like my videos, leave a like and subscribe. So first thing we are going to make is the material for the smoke. So for that, right click, then material. I will name this m_smoke, then open it up and we will grab a texture from the starter content. So this T smoke tile texture, then bring it here, then change the blend mode to translucent and the shading model to unlit. So now we just have the MSC color and opacity. So now duplicate this, so we get this two texture samples. Now get a texture coordinate, so press U and click. Then a panner, P and click, and connect this to the coordinate, and connect this to the UV. Then duplicate both of this, then connect this to the UVs here. Now change the panning speed to 1 for the speed X, and the coordinate should be the same. So for the second texture, we will change the panning speed to 0.5 for X, and for the tiling we will give a value of 0.5 and 0.5, so it will make the texture twice as big. So now we will multiply both of them together. So now it looks like this. So as you can see, it has made our texture a bit darker. So to make it a bit more lighter, we will multiply this with 2 and multiply it by 2, so it will be a little bit more brighter. So now we get this panning texture. To make this look like a smoke, we need to multiply this with a radial gradient. So get a new multiply, then right click and type in radial gradient, and connect this to the B. So now we have this kind of a shape. So now get a new multiply and connect this here, and we will get a depth fade node and connect this to the B. So what this will do is that whenever our smoke gets close to another mesh, it will fade, so you won't see any harsh edges when the smoke intersect with another edge. So now we will get a new multiply and connect this to the A, and we will get a particle color node. So right click and particle color, and connect the alpha to B. This allows us to control the alpha of our material through the particle system. So now after all this is done, drag and clamp this. So if any value is going above 1 or 0, we can clamp that between 0 and 1, and now connect this to the opacity. So now we get this kind of a shape. So to get the fake volumetric effect, we are going to add color to our smoke, so it will kind of look like there is some shadows inside. So to get that, we will get a linear gradient. So here one is a vertical gradient and the other one is a horizontal gradient. So if we multiply both of them together, we will get something that looks like this. So here both this gradient value is 1, and here both this gradient value is 0. So we get a shape like this. We will use this to color our smoke. So now I will get a new multiply and connect this to B, and I will get a scalar parameter and connect this to B here, and I will name this boost. So this will allow us to boost the color of our smoke. I will give a default value of 2. Then we will get a clamp and connect this here. And for min, we will get a new scalar. So press S and click, so we have the scalar and connect this to min. And I will name this min. And the default value, I will give a value of 0.5. And a slider, min should be 0 and the max should be 1. So now the 0 value, the 0th value and the value between 0 and 0.5 will be mapped to 0.5, because we have a 0.5 here. So we can control this in the material instance later to control our smoke. Now get a new multiply and connect this to here and connect this to B. So if you want to color the smoke, you can use this and connect this to the emissy color. So get a smoke that looks like this. Now we will create our particle system. So right click and particle system. I will name this P_smoke and open it up. Then in the required, I will just create a material instance and click this arrow. So our material gets added. So now the first thing I'm going to do is give an initial rotation to this. So get an rotation, initial rotation, not rotation rate. Rotation rate will continue to rotate the particle throughout its life, and initial rotation will only offset the rotation during the start. So that's all we need to do there, between 0 and 1. Now I will change the initial size. I will lock this to the XYZ axis and change the X value to maybe 80 and the min value to 75. Now we will change the lifetime to 0.49 and 5. It started raining here. I don't know if you can hear the noise or not. I'm sorry if you can. So we get something that looks like this. Now we will play around with the alpha. So go to color over time. Then click this graph icon. So we get this graph. Now click on this yellow on the color overlay. So we get that disabled. So this one is the alpha over time. We will bring that to 0 and we will click on this auto and we will just adjust this like this. So make it touch 1. So it will start at 0 and also end at 0. So it will be at maximum value when the lifetime of the particle is at 35%. Then it will fall down to 0. So we will get this kind of fading effect. So the next thing to add is the size over life. So go to size, size by life, and click on the graph and click on the yellow of the alpha over life. So we can not see that. So we get only this life multiplier. Now I will go here and change the locked axis to XYZ. So we get a single point. So I will bring this to 0 and auto. Now I will adjust this and I will then I will bring this to 0 also and adjust it like that. So now we get a smoke that looks like this. We can also adjust the initial size and adjust the curve and adjust the final size And I will adjust the curve. You can always add more points here and control it that way. So now we have our smoke. Let's bring that here. Now we can control the color. So check boost and min. Then we will decrease this value so it kind of gets a bit darker. We can also decrease this value to like 1, so our smoke will be very dark. I'm just going to leave it at 2. It is lagging for some reason, I don't really know. We only used like 20 particles here, so you can always increase it if you want. Play around with this value so you get the result you want. Let me check the value of this. 2 and 0.2, so I will change this to 0.2. So yeah, now we have our shadowing of our smoke. So that's it. Thanks for watching guys, and subscribe for more tutorials like this. Thanks.